Hello, everybody. Welcome back. Thanks to everybody who left comments on last week's video. It was getting a bit steamy and filthy with love in Central America. I feel as though I know some of you a lot better now after your comments on last week's video. But anyway, the two people who are winning copies of that book are Chris Adams and Monica Hira. Congratulations, both of you. You'll find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your postal addresses and I'll get books off to you as soon as I can. Last week I was having an affair. This week I'm having a baby. That escalated quickly. It's Nutshell, the new novel from Ian McEwan. Now, any new novel from Ian McEwan is going to be something of an event. But there is something in particular about this book which I think is exciting. You may already have seen some reviews, all of which have been amazing so far. But I had the chance to speak to Ian McEwan at a couple of events about this book over the last few months. And I could tell then that there was something in, there's a little glint in his eye when he talks about writing this book and getting the idea for it, where you can tell that he's had a lot of fun writing it. And that it's kind of, in fact, there's a little video. I'm going to put links to a couple of videos down below and also above my head. You can hear him reading from the book. And you can also hear him sort of introducing it, talking about it. And you'll see at the end of that second video, he says that he felt a bit more like his 22-year-old self when writing this book rather than the 67-year-old self that he is. And that's, on its own, might be enough to make a lot of readers' ears prick up. I speak to people who sometimes say, you know, I prefer early McEwan. And what they mean by that often is that early McEwan, and I reviewed or sort of, you know, spoke about his debut story collection here, First Love, Last Rites, which celebrated its 40th anniversary. I'll put a link to that video as well. It's an amazing story collection. It's incredibly brave and creative and dark and twisted. So much invention in there. And I think that's what they mean when they talk about enjoying early McEwan. He was quite a almost controversial writer when he first started. And I think people have become very used to him writing these sort of middle-class professional novels of his later career. And, you know, he's been very honest about the fact that he didn't want to be known as the kind of person you could go up to and kind of go, so what profession are you going to be writing about next? You know, is it going to be a lawyer? Is it going to be a doctor? All very sort of, as I say, saving middle class. So he wanted to do something a little bit different. And whilst he was at this conference, this line came to him and this idea, and then he just started writing and then couldn't stop. And if you don't already know, the clue is in the cover. Nutshell is narrated by an unborn fetus. 2 weeks from birth, we get to hear the voice of this baby. Now, straight away, you might have alarm bells going off, going, how can a baby narrate a book? How can a fetus know anything about the world around it if it can't see it or hear it? Well, it can hear. And what McEwan does rather brilliantly is to suggest that this fetus, during its 9-month gestation, has learnt an awful lot about the world because his mother, Trudy, is a big fan of listening to the radio and to podcasts and things like that. And so he has learnt not only about the state of world affairs, but also about wine. She's listened to a 15-episode podcast series all about knowing your wine. So he knows an awful lot about that, also because she's rather fond of drinking wine herself. And so he can sort of sample and taste the wine that she drinks, you know, through the umbilical cord, and has a lot of fun with that. And all the sort of worries that you might have about the conceit of this book, if you really want to, you can keep holding those up and ruin the enjoyment. But my suggestion would be to maybe just lower the defences slightly, go with it, because it is one of the funniest books I've read this year. It is just, as I said, him having an awful lot of fun writing. Amazing conceit, I think. Very, very funny. And what he's doing is sort of almost retelling the Hamlet story, but with this sort of unborn narrator, which is a really clever idea. And the idea of having a thriller where the person who might be able to sort of have an impact on it is, of course, unable to do anything, has to be an observer, but then might become more active, obviously, as time goes on. I don't want to give too much away, obviously, with the plot, but there's a lot of fun to be had about character. There's a lot of fun to be had with the sort of standard plot of a thriller. And the language throughout the book is just delicious. McEwan has always been a great crafter of a sentence. But you can see that he's really cutting loose here, because this fetus who has learnt things from the radio and from podcasts has got this amazing turn of phrase. knows more words than you or I probably do and is able to sort of, you know, create these wonderful sentences. So you can just see that as a writer, he's really having fun, flexing his muscles and having a great laugh along the way. So there's just so much to recommend this book. It's relatively short. I read it, you know, quickly, but enjoyed myself so much whilst I was reading it. And that's why I think so many of the reviews I've seen have been loving it, because it's just, yeah, like, you know, you hear that thing all the time, they kind of go, a writer at the height of his powers, and it all sounds terribly serious. Well, this is a writer at the height of his powers, but not sort of wielding a great club around, but with a sort of, you know, like with an épée sword or something, just having a great fun, great flourish, and really enjoying his writing. It leaps off the page in that way, and that's what makes it such an enjoyable experience for the reader. So there you go. I hope that's enough to give you a clue about Nutshell. As I said, there's links to the videos below where you can hear him reading. You can read an extract yourself on our website or hear him talking a little bit more about the book. But I loved it. So there you go. That is Nutshell by Ian McEwan. Available now. So there you go. I have two copies as ever to give away. If you are interested, please leave a comment below. Make sure you're a subscriber, and I'll pick a couple of winners next week, where I will be doing a very different video, a much, much longer book, another for the 2016 Classics Challenge. You'll have to find out what book it is then. But thank you for joining me this week, and I'll see you next week. Take care.